As a warning sign that if you talk enough sense, then you'll lose your mind. And I'll use you as a focal point, so I don't lose sight of what I want.
Hey, what's up, you guys? Yes, today we're gonna be doing another creepy video. Now, today's video, we're gonna be talking about something that I am obsessed with. Oh, hi Cheeto. Are you scared? It's okay, Daddy got you. Yes, we're gonna be talking about creepy hidden messages in songs. Now, just a couple weeks ago, we talked about how if you reverse Britney Spears' song, Hit Me Baby One More Time, you can hear her saying, "Sleep with me, I'm not too young." And there's so many other subliminal messages supposedly found in music and music videos. Now, we've talked about it before that a lot of people think Taylor Swift has a lot of Illuminati symbols in her videos, or that she references the devil. And people even think that Justin Bieber has subliminal messages happening in his music videos, especially the one where he had the text behind him popping up in and out. But there is so much more than just that. So today we're gonna be talking about a few of the creepy. Now, this first one we're gonna talk about isn't even subliminal. It's right there for you to hear for yourself. And that is the true meaning behind the song, Hotel California. So in 1977, there was a band named The Eagles who were huge. And one of their biggest songs ever was Hotel California. Now, I'm sure you've heard your aunt do karaoke to this song, and you've heard this song your whole life, but have you actually listened to the lyrics? Because they are crazy. Now, before I play you those lyrics, let me give you a little background information on what people think this song is actually about. People think the lyrics in this song are not about a hotel, but in fact, they're about cults, witchcraft, sex slavery, demons, and human sacrifice. Now, in the song, it is said that if you reverse it, you can hear him talking about Satan. So here's a piece of the song playing normally. And now here is that same piece of the song, but backwards. I know, fucking creepy. And that's not even the scariest part of the song. There are lyrics that aren't reversed that are just as creepy as that. I mean, this next part of the song is very clearly about going to hell and seeing the devil. Listen.
And in the master's chambers, they're gathered for the feast. They stab it with their stealing eyes, but they just can't kill the beast.
And they even refer to Satan as the nightmare. Now, a lot of people think that the frontman of the Eagles sold his soul to the devil. Like we've talked about before, a lot of musicians supposedly sold their soul to the devil to get famous. And not only does he sing about the devil in this song, if you look at the album cover art and you zoom in behind the party, some people say that you could see Satan hiding in the shadows. Whew. That's so much creepier than the Britney Spears one, like by a million. All right, so this next song we're gonna talk about is very surprising because when you listen to it, it just sounds like a fun pop song, but it's not. So there's a song out there called Big Hoops by an artist named Nelly Furtado. And she's a pop artist. She makes really fun, boppy songs. But in this song, she put in a hidden message that you can only hear when you reverse it. Okay, so let's play the song normal and listen for the weird talking.
It ain't over yet.
I can go fast.
Okay, now when you reverse that, this is what she says.
Oh my god, descending to the 13th floor of fortune.
Yeah, she's talking very specifically about the number 13 on the 13th floor, and as you guys know, we've talked about it before, 13 is a very important number to the Illuminati. So is she talking about being in the Illuminati or trying to get away from the Illuminati? I mean, if you look at the music video, she literally does the symbol. Creepier. Have you ever noticed that elevators usually don't have a 13th floor? They don't. It's said that 85% of elevators do not have a 13th floor because they think it's unlucky. Now listen, I don't know exactly what she means by this, but she clearly put it in there for a reason, so I guess guess we'll never know. All right, now this next story is really sad and just intense. And that is the story of a Judas Priest song that led two people to try to kill themselves. In 1979, Judas Priest had a song called Better By You, Better Than Me. And in 1990, a 20-year-old man named James Vance and a 19-year-old man named Ray Belknap went to a playground of a local church and shot themselves in the head. Now, Ray died instantly, but James survived. He ultimately killed himself a few years later, but when he survived the gunshot, he was left with a horribly disfigured face. Now, you're probably wondering, what does this have to do with the song? Well, the families of Ray and James sued Judas Priest because they said that there were subliminal messages in the song that led their children to try to kill themselves. Now, supposedly, when you listen to the song, you can hear a subliminal, "Do it! Do it!" And of course, the parents are claiming that that is what led their kids to. So here is that clip of the song. Listen to see if you can hear it in the background. You can say, but I only can see. Did you hear it? Let's play it one more time. You can say, but I only can see. Now, Judas Priest actually had to go to court. Like, this became a serious thing. Just listen to them in court saying that there are no subliminal messages.
Are there subliminal do-its on the Better By You, Better Than Me song?
Absolutely not.
Well, here is a video of James talking about the incident after he survived his suicide attempt. Check it out.
About 5 pounds of arguments over music. I mean, it wasn't over drugs, it wasn't over alcohol, it was over the music.
I know. Fucking heartbreaking. Now, the lawsuit was thrown out because there was no merit. Like, they could not prove that. But ultimately, two people did lose their lives, and they blame a song. Okay, so this next song is not subliminal, it's just fucking creepy. And that is the song called People Say I'm No Good by Charles Manson. Now, Charles Manson is a very evil man, and he even claims to be the devil. Like, that's how evil he is.
Is Charlie Manson crazy?
Well, whatever that means. Sure, he's crazy as mad as a hatter. What difference does it make? You know, a long time ago, being crazy meant something. Nowadays, everybody's crazy.
Yeah. Just check out how crazy he actually is.
What do you think it is about you that makes people want to be a part of whatever it is you're a part of?
I'm brand new. Everything I do is always brand new. I'm on the premise of reality. I walk a real road. I'm a real person inside. I'm not a phony. I don't put on no airs. I say what I think. You see what I'm saying?
Now, Charles Manson got life in prison for what he did, and he's still there. He's still alive. And this is one of his songs that he wrote and sang, and it's called People Say I'm No Good. Check it out.
Everybody says you're no good. Cause Charles, you don't do like they think you should. You expect them to act like you.
Just hearing that song and knowing what he did, it's just, oh. Now, speaking of music and murder, this next story is insane. This is the story of a song called Texas Boy. In 2000, there was a hip-hop artist named Big Lurch. He released a song called Texas Boy that talks about cutting people up with a machete and becoming a killer. Here's a clip of that song, and it's pretty intense.
I'm in this game heavy, boy, already.
Now, 2 years after he released that song, a neighbor found him standing in front of an apartment building, naked, covered in blood, staring at the sky. Inside the apartment that he was standing in front of was the body of a 25-year-old woman named Tanisha, who had just been brutally murdered with a knife. She was found with her chest torn open and teeth marks on her face. Now, the teeth marks weren't just from him biting her. The cops found out that he started to eat her, and he ate some of her organs. Now, supposedly this occurred because he went on a meth binge the day before, but some people think maybe that's just an excuse. Either way, he is in prison and he will be there for the rest of his life. And now if you go back and listen to that song, it makes it even scarier.
Rocking up cocaine and selling weed, the devilish, mischievous child, the bad seed.
Now, this last song we're going to talk about doesn't have any hidden messages in it. It's just kind of a hidden song that's very scary. In 1995, Michael Jackson released a compilation album called History. And inside that album was a song called Little Susie. Now, before we get into what this song is about, just listen to the very beginning of it and tell me it's not one of the creepiest songs you've ever heard. Yeah, literally like from a horror movie. Now, some of the lyrics are incredibly disturbing. I'm gonna read some of them because I don't want to get copyrighted, but it's a lot. Somebody killed little Susie, the girl with the tune, and she was there screaming, beating her voice in her doom. A fall down the stairs, her dress torn, oh, the blood in her hair. She lies there so tenderly, fashioned so slenderly. Lift her with care, oh, the blood in her hair. Now, supposedly this song was written about a real murder, but nobody can figure it out because nobody can find the real story. But there is a legend that if you listen to this song with headphones in a dark room, and then after you call out to little Susie, she might answer you. That is no. I mean, I'll probably do it at some point. Maybe I'll do that as a separate video. Not right now, because I can't handle that right now. But I guess the scariest part is we'll never know, because Michael Jackson wrote the song and he's passed, so the secret is with him. Okay, so those are a few of the creepiest songs ever and some really creepy hidden messages inside of them. But I wanted to delve a little deeper into this whole world. Now, a couple weeks ago, if you guys remember, I did a conspiracy theory video where I talked about a channel called Vida Subliminal. Now, that channel makes a bunch of videos that are supposed to help you with your life, all through like subliminal messages. Supposedly, if you watch one, it can turn your green eyes brown. Now, once I put that video up, I got actually a lot of hate from people who make videos like this and who love videos like that. And they were saying, Shane, you just don't understand it. It works. Well, then I got an email from a channel called Mind Audio Central. And this channel makes very similar videos to Vida Subliminal. Here's one that supposedly, if you watch, will turn your hair blonde. Now, he reached out to me and said, Shane, I want to explain to you how this works, because it does in fact work. And I was like, you know what? Let's do an interview, because I really got to hear what he has to say. So without further ado, here is my interview with Mind Audio Central. Check it out. Okay, guys, I am here with Mind Audio Central. Now, can you please introduce who you are and what you do?
So basically, I made the term Mind Audio to cover a variety of like different topics and different audios that people have been uploading on YouTube. And I've sort of created my channel as a place where, you know, everybody can get that all like in one place. So there's things like subliminals, like binaurals, all that type of stuff. You know, they can get it all in one place.
So you reached out to me after I did the conspiracy video, because you were like, listen, like, this is a real thing, it's not a conspiracy, but it's also not creepy, and you were trying to explain it to me, and I was like, fuck it, let's just do an interview, because I'm very fascinated. So yeah. You really do believe that if you watch a video that tells you that you're going to get green eyes, that it could work?
So the whole thing is, you don't, like, watch a video, it's actually, like, the audio that's in there, and, you know, basically what it is, it's just, it's, like, messages in there, you know, and, you know, as you kind of talked about in your video, you know, like, oh, what are they doing, you know, and we just hide affirmations or those messages in music and other things, and they go to the subconscious, and it basically tells your subconscious, like, hey, this change needs to be made, because your mind is like a very powerful, like, body part, you know, it controls so many things that are happening that you don't know, you know, you're, you know, taking control of. Like, obviously you don't need to consciously think like, oh, I need to breathe, or, you know, my liver needs to do like its hundreds of functions, and, you know, by like talking to the subconscious, sending messages to it, you can get it to change different things, basically.
So underneath, so you'll have like music playing, and then really low in the music, it'll be like, you need to change your eye color or something like that.
Yeah.
So then how does that actually manifest into changing something? Can your brain change your eye color?
Well, I think for another instance, because this is a more popular video on my channel, I have a Get Shorter subliminal. And, you know, basically what happens there is when people, like, keep listening to those affirmations, like, once a day or something, you know, they have a schedule, you know, it keeps pushing those affirmations to the subconscious, you know, and it's telling your body, like, oh, the, you know, sponginess of, like, your bones is changing, that sort of thing, you know, telling different things to change. And, I mean, a lot of people have said in the comments that they've gotten results. Some people have, like, taken pictures. So, I mean, it's just, it seemed to be, like, a big success. And I think the whole thing is also just, it's the amount of time that it takes. Like, some people are impatient and they listen once and they're like, you know, is this a joke? Like, you know, is this real or whatever? But I think the biggest thing is that it definitely takes patience. Like, it's not something that just happens, like, in 2 seconds.
Well,
so.
I am not surprised because, I mean, I've heard for years that your brain, you're only using, what, like, 3% of it or 10% of it or something really crazy low. And if you use the whole 100%, you could do some crazy shit, like that movie Lucy, where she's like moving shit around. So if you're tapping into that part of your brain, maybe you could change your body or things in your life. Like, maybe it's almost like magic, but real.
I mean, the brain Yeah, the brain is amazing, but I will say that it is a myth. I think a more accurate statement would be we're not using 100% of our brain, like, all the time, because there's different lobes we only use in specific situations. But yeah, no, the subconscious is a very powerful thing. You know, it is kind of the background of, like, everybody. And it can, you know, kind of stores different things, I guess you could say, you know, whether you have social anxiety or things like that. You know, it's like, it's all in there, and it can all be, like, changed, and you just have to learn how to tap into it.
Do you think, though, that this could be used for evil? I mean, what if, you know, the government starts putting out all these audios on TV or radio, or what if, you know, record labels figure it out and they start promoting things through the music? Is that something that could happen?
Well, first of all, like, it started in advertising. They basically played, like, subliminals in a movie theater to, you know, sell popcorn and soda. And they looked at this and they were like, holy cow, this is, like, so effective. There's no way we should make this legal. So by my knowledge in advertising, subliminals were made illegal in those. And it's why they're, like, really elaborate. I actually once saw this whole thing with an AARP commercial. It was really quiet, but you could hear, like, something blasting from the TV in the background, and if you, like, turned it up enough, you would actually hear something in there. So, I mean, they could already be doing that, so I don't know.
Oh my god.
It's a little scary, but it's also just, we don't want to freak people out either, because then when they go to our videos, they're thinking, you know, like, oh no, this is totally bad. But we want to be able to let people know what the difference is between, like, you know, people using it in advertising and people, I guess if you wanted to say, reverse engineering it for the public's benefit. So it's a double-edged sword.
Now, do you think that subliminal messages can be used for good? Like, could this be used to help people get over, you know, smoking or dieting or, you know, even, like, learning disabilities?
Yeah, subliminals, they're a double-edged sword. It really depends on, you know, what you're using them for, that sort of thing. You know, people can use them in commercials for bad things, but, you know, we can also engineer them for great things. And I think the whole thing is, like, the things you explained right there are kind of, they can be subconscious behaviors. They can be things kind of hidden in there. And yeah, I mean, those behaviors could be changed with subliminals.
Wow. Yeah. Well, there you guys go. Go check out his channel, Mind Audio Central, if you want to change things in your life. I'm going to be trying it. Subliminal messaging could be used for good. It also could be used for bad, but either way, it is very, very real. Well, there you guys go. Subliminal messages are very real, and they can be used for positives, but they also can be used for negatives. I don't know. I just find all of this stuff fascinating. The hidden meanings in songs, subliminal messages in advertising, all of it is just very fascinating to me. So there you guys go. If you want me to do another video about subliminal messages, maybe in movies or TV shows, give me a thumbs up so I know. Also, make sure to subscribe to my channel right down below and hit the notification bell because I make new videos every day. And if you want to see my other videos where I talk about conspiracy theories and stuff, I'll put a link to a playlist right at the top of the description below. All right, you guys, I'll see you tomorrow. Be careful what you hear.